Trump's attacks on CNN helped their revenues far more than his praise helped Fox News. New figures suggest Donald Trump's favorite channel Fox News has experienced a year-on-year drop in advertising revenue, while CNN and the New York Times continue to grow despite the president attacking them as fake news and failing. Despite the president constantly tweeting his love of Fox News, the right-wing, unashamedly pro-Trump network suffered a 2% drop in advertising revenue for the third quarter of 2017 compared to the same period last year, analyst Standard Media Index (SME) have revealed. By contrast, CNN repeatedly branded fake news by Mr. Trump saw its third quarter ad revenues grow by 9% year-on-year. And the day after Mr. Trump told his 43.5 meters Twitter followers that MSNBC had terrible ratings, SME's National TV Index report showed the network's third quarter ad revenues had grown year-on-year by an impressive 22%. Meanwhile, the New York Times, the newspaper Mr. Trump calls failing an enemy of the people, has announced it is gaining 100,000 subscribers a quarter, up from the pre-election growth rate of 23,000-33,000 new subscribers a quarter. The newspaper's chief executive, Mark Thompson, told Marketing Week that subscriptions were building very nicely on the back of Mr. Trump's outbursts. UK media commentator Alice Enders, head of research at Enders Analysis, told The Independent, "These figures suggest the so-called Trump bump is helping the media he attacks more than Fox News." She explained that most media, whether leaning to the left or right, had grown thanks to the massive appetite for news generated by the 2016 election and Mr. Trump's hectic, drama-filled presidency. But Ms. Enders said the Fox figures the first year-on-year decrease in one of the big three U.S. cable news networks since the 2016 election might mean that the media outlets Mr. Trump attacks are the ones benefiting the most. One potential reason for this, said Ms. Enders, was that in launching constant attacks on the fake news media, Mr. Trump is also giving an awful lot of free publicity to CNN. He is effectively advertising CNN to people who don't like Trump, and let us not forget his approval ratings are incredibly low and have been declining. In turn, the appeal of these news channels to advertisers is driven first and foremost by the size of their audiences. Ms. Enders added that the subscription growth of the New York Times suggested Mr. Trump's attacks were providing a similar boost for the newspaper. Part of that growth, said Ms. Enders, is people saying, "Donald Trump hates the New York Times. Therefore I like the New York Times." Ben Fenton, the former chief media correspondent of the Financial Times who runs a media consultancy at global communications firm Edelman, added, "There is a sense in the U.S. that Trump's support is retreating to a very hardcore, which would be supported by those statistics." Mr. Fenton said a single year-on-year fall did not necessarily signify a general trend towards an overall decline in Fox News advertising revenue, and both commentators said that the comparison between the third quarters of 2017 and 2016 would be a particularly tough one for the network. Ms. Enders said this was because it was a comparison between 2017 and what was likely to have been a boom period for Fox News, which probably drew in more political advertising than its less overtly partisan rivals during the 2016 election. She said, "It is very possible that politically motivated advertising as the election campaign intensified would have been much more attracted to Fox News than CNN, which is actually not viewed as a Democrat mouthpiece. It remains to be seen whether